A newborn giraffe or foal must learn to walk on its legs as fast as possible to avoid predators. Animals are born with muscle coordination networks located in their spinal cord. However, learning the precise coordination of leg muscles and tendons takes some time. Initially, baby animals rely heavily on hardwired spinal cord reflexes. While somewhat more basic, motor control reflexes help the animal to avoid falling and hurting themselves during their first walking attempts. The following more advanced and precise muscle control must be practiced until eventually the nervous system is well adapted to the young animal's leg muscles and tendons. No more uncontrolled stumbling, the young animal can now keep up with the adults. Researchers at the Max Planck Institute for Intelligent Systems in Stuttgart conducted a research study to find out how animals learn to walk and learn from stumbling. They built a four-legged dog-sized robot that helped them figure out the details. After learning to walk in just 1 hour, the researcher Felix Ruppert's robot makes good use of its complex leg mechanics. A Bayesian optimization algorithm guides the learning. The measured foot sensor information is matched with target data from the modeled virtual spinal cord running as a program in the robot's computer. The robot learns to walk by continuously comparing scent and expected sensor information, running reflex loops, and adopting its motor control patterns. The learning algorithm adopts control parameters of a central pattern generator, CPG. In humans and animals, these central pattern generators are networks of neurons in the spinal cord that produce periodic muscle contractions without input from the brain. Central pattern generator networks aid the generation of rhythmic tasks such as walking, blinking, or digestion. Furthermore, reflexes are involuntary motor control actions triggered by hard-coded neural pathways that connect sensors in the leg with the spinal cord. As long as the young animal walks over a perfectly flat surface, CPGs can be sufficient to control the movement signals from the spinal cord. A small bump on the ground, however, changes the walk. Reflexes kick in and adjust the movement patterns to keep the animal from falling. These momentary changes in the movement signals are reversible or elastic, and the movement patterns return to their original configuration after the disturbance. But if the animal does not stop stumbling over many cycles of movement, despite active reflexes, then the movement patterns must be relearned and made plastic, that is, irreversible. In the newborn animal, CBGs are initially not yet adjusted well enough and the animal stumbles around, both on even or uneven terrain. But the animal rapidly learns how its CBGs and reflexes control legs, muscles and tendons. The same holds true for the Labrador-sized robot dog named Morti. Even more, the robot optimizes its movement patterns faster than an animal in about 1 hour. Morti's CPG is simulated on a small and lightweight computer that controls the motion of the robot's legs. This virtual spinal cord is placed on the quadruped robot's back where the head would be. During the hour it takes for the robot to walk smoothly, sensor data from the robot's feet are continuously compared with the expected touchdown predicted by the robot's CPG. If the robot stumbles, the learning algorithm changes how far the legs swing back and forth, how fast the legs swing, and how long a leg is on the ground. The adjusted motion also affects how well the robot can utilize its compliant leg mechanics. During the learning process, the CPG sends adapted motor signals so that the robot henceforth stumbles less and optimizes its walking. In this framework, the virtual spinal cord has no explicit knowledge about the robot's leg design, its motors and springs. Knowing nothing about the physics of the machine, it lacks a robot model. Ruppert says that their robot is practically born knowing nothing about its leg anatomy or how they work. The CPG resembles a built-in automatic walking intelligence that nature provides and that they have transferred to the robot. The computer produces signals that control the leg's motors and the robot initially walks and stumbles. Data flows back from the sensors to the virtual spinal cord where sensor and CPG data are compared. If the sensor data does not match the expected data, the learning algorithm changes the walking behavior until the robot walks well and without stumbling. Changing the CPG output while keeping reflexes active and monitoring the robot's stumbling is a core part of the learning process. Morti's computer draws only 5 watts of power in the process of walking. Industrial quarter-depth robots from prominent manufacturers, which have learned to run with the help of their complex controllers, are much more power-hungry. Their controllers are coded with the knowledge of the robot's exact mass and body geometry using a model of the robot. They typically draw several tens up to several hundred watts of power. Both robot types run dynamically and efficiently, but the computational energy consumption is far lower in the Stuttgart model. It also provides important insights into animal anatomy. This is fundamental research at the intersection between robotics and biology. The robotic model gives answers to questions that biology alone can't answer.